Hey folks, welcome back to the farm. I'm gonna kind of go over the equipment I use to bale hay for a small scale hay operation, and most importantly, why I even fool with it. So I'm gonna start it with my equipment, and this is the first thing you use is a hay cutter. This is a old sickle bar mower. It's a New Holland 451 belt drive. I've had this for years. And I'll go over all the costs too. So this, I gave $450 for this, but several years ago. I've had it for about 12 years, I think. And the big thing about it is the belt drive. I started out with a Pitman arm, Ford 501, I think. And it's slow, won't cut thick grass, thick hay, won't cut, hardly cut anything. So, I mean, you had to go in first gear. This thing right here, I can go and fourth gear, and it cuts really good, and ain't got no complaints at all with it. I just keep it greased. These knives, I've had them for, I'm thinking maybe 4 or 5 years, and I'm gonna have to replace them next year. I think I'll get one more year out of them, but this is a fine piece of equipment for $450 to get you in the hay cutting business. There's all kinds of different kinds of cutters you can buy, and but this is the one that's kind of cheapest at the time. And of course, you know, they got new disc mowers, they got drum mowers, they got mowers with conditioners and all that, but you know, you're getting a lot more money than this. $450 to lay your hay down is what they used, you know, in the 70s and 60s, and I think this is a 70 something model, so it's been real good for me, and I would highly recommend one of these. Let's move on. After we cut it, you know, it lays there and dries for a few days, and then we rake it up in windrows. So let's look at the rake I use. So this is the rake I'm using currently. This is a Massey Ferguson 35, and I really love this rake and this type of rake. I've also got a New Holland 256, and when we did the, we used to do 50 something acres and round bales, and I would pull this, my son would pull the New Holland. Or vice versa. This is, I like this a lot better. It's a lot heavier. You get your momentum going, build up, and it'll rake hay like crazy. New Holland tends to me, skip a little bit. So you're getting some heavy hay and it'll skip. But this thing is awesome. This is the second Massey Ferguson 35 I've owned. When I first got, you know, 30 or 25 years ago, I had one. Sold it, thinking the New Holland was better. So a guy I work with was selling this one, and so I bought it, and I gave $500 for this. Now I'm going to do some work on this too. Obviously, everything I need is needs pressure washing painted, but I don't have an equipment shed right now, so everything stays outside. So one of my goals this winter is to build an equipment shed, and I got to replace some of the rake teeth. I got to do that and wash it, and we'll paint it, and everything else is good now. My son lost his little drive shaft here. There's a shaft that goes from here to there and makes both wheels turn. This is a ground drive. So actually the wheels turn that chain, and it turns the PTO and it goes into the gearbox. So as long as you're moving, it's turning. And you can turn it off right there if you need to. But when you make a sharp turn, sometimes or a wide turn, that's why you need both wheels pulling. But we lost it somewhere in some hay field, and snuck in the world, we still use it. So this is a really good option, $500. So I'm up to $950 right now. We got it cut, we got it laying on the ground, and we got it raked into windrows. So now what we do? Well, now we bale. So let's go over and look at the baler I use. So this is my baler. This is a third baler I've owned. This is a John Deere 24T. I believe it's a 61 or 2 model. I need to verify that with the serial number. You can still get parts for it, believe it or not. Because I broke one of the knotters and went to my John Deere dealer, and he got it like the next day. I mean it's pricey, but you know, at least you can still get parts for them. But this does really good. Got no complaints with this baler. I haven't done really much to it except for that. I keep it oil, keep it greased, and then it'll go. Don't take a whole lot of horsepower. Now I pull it with my 55 horse John Deere. And I mean, you really don't even know it's back there. I should have tried it with my TYM 48 horse. Pulled this with my Ford Jubilee, which I think is a 30-something horse, and it pulled it fine. And no problems, so. It's a lot easier with my John Deere. John Deere, you don't even know it's back there. But this is a square baler, because you know you got round balers too. And I've got one of those, but I won't sell it. I don't use it anymore. But you know, it picks it up in the chamber, or in the, I guess that is the chamber. It throws it into the baling chamber. And it's got a big ram right here's the ram. You can see it. It goes back and forth, and then it packs that hay in there. Like this. This goes back and forth. And here's your feed arm. That's what throws your hay into the baler chamber. And then you got all your strings here. And when it gets to, you set your bale length with this device right here. You move this up and down. So this is really worn and it's not real accurate, so I don't get a real consistent length of bale. Then, but when it hits this right here and it comes back up, and right here's your knotters. It'll tie a knot. Let me see if I can find one. Right here's a good knot. It's really a piece of engineering marvel, if you ask me. If you sit there and watch it, it's pretty amazing. I've got no problems with this. Now, I had a New Holland 68 before this one, and it would banana bale a lot of the bales. This right here, I've never had any problems. You can set it up, go with it. Once it starts going, you don't have any problems. So I would highly recommend this for an old baler, 24T. I think they're all about the same, 36 or the 33, I say 336 model, I think is the next one. Basically the same thing, it's just a little bit bigger pickup, a little faster stroke. So when you move up into that, the one before this, the 14T, was a little slower. This is a 24T, so when you move on up, it gets a little faster. But I haven't got that much to go, so that's why I just keep this as long as it works. So you might say, by the way, I gave $750 for my baler. So I've got what? 450, fives, 950, $1,700 in my equipment. Not counting my tractor, which I gotta have anyway. And I've had this for, gosh, how long have I had all this stuff? I don't know, 10 years. Let's just take the last 3 years. If I do 100 bales, I want 100 bales this year, $7 a bale. That's $700. It would cost me. So if I just over 3 years, that's $2,100. So I'm saving money by doing it myself. And yeah, it's a little bit harder work, but you know what you get. I don't use herbicides. I don't use any kind of chemical fertilizer on my hay field. All I do is run my chickens through there, my sheep through there. They fertilize it, they weed it. Now, it's not perfect horse hay, you know, $35 a bale hay, but it's really pretty good hay. And that's the reason I do that, because we feed it to our milk goats. Well, I don't want the herbicide. You know, there's a thing going around now called persistent herbicide that passes through the animal into, you know, their manure and their byproducts. So I don't have to worry about none of that. I don't want none of that in my body. It's just like now people's buying the compost with the horse manure or cow manure, and it's killing their vegetable plants. So that's something to check into, and I might do a whole video on that. But I ain't got that problem. I ain't got to worry about that. Even when I clean out the barn, put it in my mulch pile or my compost pile, don't have to worry about it. So that's the main reason. I control what my animals eat, which in turn is what we eat. So I think that's very important. I ain't got to worry about no herbicide coming through, no Roundup, nothing of that stuff. It's all clear. So that's the main reason I do it, because I think I'm saving money, which I know I'm saving money, and I know what's going into my animals' feed. So, and I mean, it's a little bit of hard work. It's a family affair. You can watch our videos and see us all load. You know, you can get, two, three people can do it, and it's not that big a deal. So I think it's worth the effort. It's worth keeping this equipment going. You know, over 10 years, I mean, I've got, if you think about it, I mean, what, $770 a year over 10 years is what it's cost me. it certainly saved me more than that. I mean, I can't even calculate. I should sit down and calculate exactly, because last year I got like 150 bales. So this year I didn't cut as much because I didn't need as much. So now I was going to sell it, but I decided against it. It's a little, I don't want to even get into that. Hey, I appreciate you watching. If you have any comments, leave a comment. I answer all comments. Send me an email. If I forget something, kind of going at a fast pace. So just let me know if you want to know something or if I'm not saying something right. I'm pretty confident on this stuff. So just let me know. You can send me an email. Hey, support your local farmer. Give me a thumbs up. Hit the subscribe button. We'll see you down in the farm next video.